Saw a video over the weekend that understandably a lot of people have been very affected by, and it shows a child sort of surveying the devastation of the most recent conflict and talking about it just openly, honestly, about the horror of the situation. I want you to take a look at this.
I'm always sick, I'm always, I don't know. I can't do anything. All of this, what do you expect me to do? Fix it? I'm only 10. I can't even do anything in this war. I just want to be a doctor or anything to help my people, but I can't. I'm just a kid. I don't even know what to do. I get scared, but not really that much. I do anything for my people, but I don't know what to do. I'm just 10. I'm just 10. All of this, when I see, I literally cry every day, saying to myself, why do we deserve this? Why? What did we do to this? My family said they just hate us. They just don't like us because we are Muslims. Why does Muslims act for you like that? You see all of the kids around me? They're just kids. Why wouldn't you just send a missile to them and kill them? It's not fair. It's not fair.
Yeah, that's just devastating, obviously. I'm just imagining yourself in the position of that kid. And I understand that plenty of Americans might watch that video. First of all, they'll never see it thanks to the media bubbles that we exist in. But if they did see it, they would not be capable of putting themselves in the position of that child or imagining what that life would be like. The immediate horror of worrying that every day that you could be killed, the long-term horror of believing that that's all that your life will ever be, is just fearing for the future and eventually potentially dying.
Yep.
Yeah. But the hope, I guess, at least one silver lining maybe, is that thanks to social media and thanks to media progressing very slightly in this issue, being willing to acknowledge the fundamental humanity of Palestinians, that maybe that video will help to convince people. Maybe critical coverage of the situation there will help move people. And it's too late for Biden. He's got decades of, you know, we'll do anything for Israel, we'll never question them, whatever, locked in. But maybe someday we'll have a president that cares about that girl and what happens to her.
Absolutely. And it's what I think the most devastating part of that video is that it doesn't matter that she's 10, you know? I mean, it's really sweet and she's so honest and it means a lot when it's conveyed by a child, of which there are so many. Like the average age in Gaza is like it's like 17 or 16, something like this. But it doesn't matter that she's 10. It doesn't matter that she's not a doctor. Doctors are being bombed. Doctors are being targeted. If she grew up to be a journalist was killed along with her two children. She was pregnant. You know, I mean, like how many more stories of this do we need? And you know, I do think though, speaking of the media, you know, as someone who used to work for AJ Plus and who has been a big fan of Al Jazeera and their international coverage, Jazeera 10 years ago was the only place that was actually covering a lot of what was going on in Israel, Palestine, in Iraq, in all these other places. And even just in the last 10 years, even since like, let's say 2009 and that war, the Gaza war, or the Israeli bombardment of Gaza in 2009, there's been a change. Like you can find out so much more information about what's actually going on, and outlets, whether it's like Vox or BuzzFeed or, you know, like it's not just TYT and Al Jazeera anymore. Like there are
Did you see John Oliver last night?
Yes, exactly. Yes.
Basically, it was a refined, funnier version of what we've been saying for the past week. Yeah,
I got jokes,
and now that can
John.
Exist.
I got jokes. No, yeah, no,
funnier
exactly.
Than what I've been saying, as less funny than you, but yes, no. and refined, and you would not have seen that 15 years ago.
Absolutely, and so like it feels like it's the same, and that's why I think we're so mad at Biden, because it's like. It's not just we'd expect this, it's look around you. The public opinion is turning, it is changing. Get on board with this. And it's because reality is showing itself that this is completely unjust. So yeah, I'm heartened. I also think that everyone does have a role to play. Look, boycott, divestment, sanctions, which is a movement that sadly a lot of Democrats have decided is somehow bad. It's a nonviolent movement to take money out of Israel and to not do contracts. contracts with, you know, a state that is brutalizing another people, right? That's the idea. So the Presbyterian Church of the United States participated in BDS, divested its holdings from Israel. Like, these are ways, that's what happened in South Africa. These are ways that we can move forward and actually affect change.
Yeah, agreed. Agreed. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.